Hey folks, Big Pauly here, aka Cudzndrips. Welcome to my next Blu-ray DVD shopping video. In a little while we're going to just head out and hit some of the shops and see what new releases there are this week. I'm also going to stop in a little place called The Range. I noticed they've got some giant Marvel and Star Wars wall canvas things in there, so going to go and have a look at them. I've actually got one here which I'll show you later on, so when we come back from the shops I'll show you that. Also I've got a Game of Thrones piece of merchandise which I got for my birthday from one of my friends, and also I'll give you a little rundown, a little show around my Steelbook collection, and also the home cinema room here, so I'll just give you a little peek there. So yeah, let's head out and see what we can find today.
Yay, here we are at our first stop for the day, which is Tesco. So let's head on in there and see if they've got any new releases this week. Here we go. Well, not a lot today, folks. It's Trolls, which they're calling the Party Edition. I don't exactly know what that means. I'm not sure about this film. It looks a bit preschool to me, but I don't know how entertaining it's going to be, so I probably won't pick this one up anyway, not just yet. But they got a 4K edition there as well. I didn't even notice this was actually in cinema, so that one must have just passed me by. A lot of the other stuff there is the same stuff from the last week or two. So yeah, there's the 4K edition. Also the party edition. This interesting one here, the mechanic. I've never seen the first film. But this is a double one, a double package. So that might be worth picking up. I don't know what the Resurrection, the second film, is like. They've got Dolby Atmos soundtrack there, so that looks good. Yeah, just the usual stuff from the last week or two. Now on the DVD section now, this looks interesting, Mythica. Not seen this one before. It looks a bit of a cross between something like, I don't know, Lord of the Rings, and I don't really know, but they always make the packaging look probably better than the film is, but yeah, that might be worth having a look. Here we are outside The Range, so we're going to head on in and I'm going to show you some of those canvas, wall canvas that I've talked about earlier on. Yeah, so here we are. I would definitely buy this if I had the wall space. This is absolutely fantastic. Avengers, $12.99, 60 by 80 centimeters, so it's quite large. I mean, just looking at it, it's absolutely beautiful. That would, as you can see the size of it, you know, to my hand, that would suit anybody's home cinema room. A couple of other ones, so we've got like a comic book one, Star Wars The Empire Strikes Back. This is quite interesting. This is Harley Quinn from Suicide Squad, but not really her, but yeah, very comical. Poor old Batman down there on the floor. Yeah, 60 by 80 as well, so it's the same size. And you've got another comic book style one for the X-Men. Most of them are around about the same size as well. Also, I would get this one as well. This one with the DC Comics cast. Yeah, so really, you know, what with the Justice League movie coming up, that'd be perfect to put on the wall and push the film. But Trolls, seems to be a lot of trolls everywhere, and they've even done a canvas of it. So I'm not sure. This one probably would not be on my wall. Nothing against the film itself, you know, I haven't even seen the film, so, but it's not, it doesn't look like it would suit my room. But yeah, The Amazing Spider-Man, another comic book style one. And Force Awaken, so that looks really nice. I wish they did a few more Force Awakens ones. This one is like the Death Troopers. I did have a look behind it to see if there's any other ones hiding there, but this seems to be the only one at the moment. Found a couple of other interesting little knickknacks in here in the range. There's some Princess Leia buns you can buy. They're the hair bun. Really cheap, $4.99, but yeah, it looks quite good. I won't be wearing them. But you see they're quite popular, I think there's only two left. And also some Yoda ears. These are funny little knickknacks. I think I'll get a funny couple of funny looks if I actually walk out of the store with those on. And some Minions glasses. And also some Avengers bits and pieces, if you can get good looks at some walkie-talkie, Iron Man and Captain America. Various little figures, galaxy heroes. He looks cute, little Taunton there. And some Avengers, this plush little one, Captain America, who's quite big actually. Although I think they've got them around the wrong way. And, well, really Spider-Man, yeah, so they look good together. Be kind of novel to have them, one on each side of a home cinema sofa. Here we are at Sainsbury's, off inside. I shouldn't imagine they've got much more than what Tesco's had. So it's a very weak this week. Yeah, pretty much the same. The only other one that I noticed on the shelf was Bloodfather with Mel Gibson. Everything else is pretty much the same as the last 2 weeks, so hopefully we'll be having a big week or two coming up. But very thin on the ground this week. There's a couple of cheapies in the £8 section. John Wick, which I suspect they're pushing that as the second film comes out next week, which I'm going to go and see, so looking forward to that. Batman and Superman for £8. Some will say, is it worth £8? But I like that film anyway. Arrow Video, that's a selection there, all the titles. It's nice they've kept them all together rather than spreading them all over the place. Couple of box sets there. We're in the DVD section now. There's a couple of newish ones. 100 Streets with Idris Elba. Haven't heard of this one either. So let me know if you've seen it, if it's any good. Might be worth picking up. Trolls there on DVD as well. Freedom, not heard of this one. Looks a bit like Master and Commander or Black Sails. Cuba Gooding Jr., so that might be alright. There's Lawless with Beau Bridges. He doesn't really do much these days. looks like another Western. This made me laugh. A couple of Star Wars straws they're trying to get rid of for £1.50. There's only got a couple of left, so if you wanted to suck on a stormtrooper or even suck on Vader himself, that's quite a novel thing. £1.50, there's nothing, is it?
Hey everyone, Big Pauly here, back from not a very big shop today. I noticed there was only maybe trolls and that was it. So there's not a big lot of big releases today. I hope you enjoyed the little tour of my Steelbooks and my home cinema room. Hopefully some bits and pieces in there either gave you a gasp or gave you a giggle. And also the canvas on the wall just behind me, which if I had room, I would have put some of the other canvas from the range that I showed you, especially the DC Comics one with all Superman and everything, and also the Marvel one. So it's a shame I haven't got the room. As I was saying earlier on, a present that I got for my birthday, which is today, so was this. It's a Game of Thrones large Joffrey action figure. To be perfectly honest, I didn't even know that these actually existed. I did start to collect the Game of Thrones Eagle Moss small figures. I think they were about 10 centimetres high, but I didn't really think much of them. The likeness wasn't that good. But I don't know if they do any other collections of these. One interesting one probably would have been that if they've done an alternative version, of him maybe laying on the floor, withering in agony with blood coming out of his eyes. So I definitely would have collected that one. So yeah, that would have been good. So I must look out for some more of those to see if they've got any other figures. I didn't buy any Blu-rays today, but the only other thing that I picked up was a rather nice case, embossed case, for Beauty and the Beast with some beautiful embossing on there. It's quite a large case, and these are basically kids' activity cases. But I mean, once you open it up, and you can see all the crap in there, the pens and everything, which basically will just get taken out and tossed. And I like to keep the tin, maybe to put the Beauty and the Beast Steelbook in. So that's nice. You probably saw behind me, I've got a couple of other ones on the bottom. So I've got the Good Dinosaur. I've got some Avengers ones as well. I like to keep them and collect them because they are very, very glossy. So, yeah, that's really nice. One other thing I noticed from my previous video from last week, although it was shot in some darkness, so I had the cap on and you couldn't really see much, and I had the Jungle Book Blue Fans edition. It wasn't a very good picture of the actual lenticular, so I thought, as we've got a bit more light now, so probably get a better shot of that. As you can see, that's a much better shot, and you can see all the depth in that. And what I'm going to be doing on my next video, I'm actually going to go through a lot of the Blue Fans ones that I've got, which are just up here. So we've got everything from Ant-Man, we've got Thor, Inside Out, Frozen, quite a few. And just go through basically the lenticulars and show you their lenticulars as opposed to the ones that I do, because I really wish that I could do a lenticular of this depth, but it's just not to be. Probably they need to get the images from the actual the studio, an authorization from the studio with the artwork, so I don't know. But anyway, I'm pleased with the ones that I do. And which you can go over to cudzndrips.com and see all the ones that are there for sale.
Hey guys, we're back home now, so I thought I'd just run through some of my steelbooks that I've got. We'll slowly go through a few of them. I've got the Suicide Squad. I decided to pick up the German one, the 3D edition, rather than the HMV one. For me, I just preferred the cover of the German one. And there's the Disney section, both the Pixar and all the animation ones, the Disney animation ones that Zevi released, some with beautiful glossy covers and some embossing on them. I did have the HMV Martian copy, the one with no title on the side, but I preferred to go for the extended version. I preferred the artwork on that one, so I was really pleased that they re-released it, especially with the title on the side. And also the HMV Hateful Eight edition, which is really scarce now. I think you can probably pick one up on eBay for about £60 or £70 sealed, so very popular. Couple of extra 300 Rise of the Empires I still have left for my group buy there. And if I can get my fingers on them, it's the Back to the Future Zevi one that they did. They did release them individually, but I really wanted to go for the trilogy one. So I'm really pleased I managed to pick up that. I haven't seen that around again, so that must be quite popular as well. Hard to get hold of. And then obviously the backwards spine ones, which are the French ones. I did originally have the titles in alphabetical order, but over time, you know, ones have got pulled out that I wanted to see or that I couldn't remember if I bought or not, so they've basically gone back where I could find a slot for them, but I will hopefully sort them out at some point. So that's one little section. So we'll head off to the home cinema room now, and I'll show you around there and the remaining blue and steel books. Now we're in the home cinema room with some more shelves. I've managed to try and keep these all in series order. So I've got all the Lord of the Rings, all the Hobbits, Fast and Furious all together. And some Fringe. I've only got the first three seasons at the moment. All the Die Hards. Yes, I do own A Good Day to Die Hard. So that's one little section. Then we've got the Game of Thrones Steelbooks, which were I purchased from Zevi. A whole collection of the Blue Fans ones. So I'm gonna pull these out in the next video so we can have a look at the lenticulars on those. These are not steelbooks, these are just Supernatural and Vampire Diaries. That's the Next Generation German steelbook collection. I don't know if they're ever going to release a Deep Space Nine steelbook collection, but I really hope so. And I don't know if there's a Black Sail Season 3 steelbook. I haven't seen it around anywhere, but would like to buy one. And this old, big old thing here is the complete Sons of Anarchy collector set, which is fairly hefty old set. Various Blu-rays. Hopefully you're going to replace the Mummy ones with the steelbooks from Italy when they come out. The old Walking Dead collection. Shame that none of them, all the titles, you know, all the sides don't match, but that's one of the things you have to live with these days. And this little collection here, these aren't steelbooks, these are actually collectible kids activity tins, but I collect them because they're actually beautiful and glossy and very embossed, so I like those. Okay, let's show you around the rest of the cinema room. As you can see, I've got a couple of large Star Wars figures from Jack Specific. Those two, Hulk and Iron Man, they were from the Eagle Moss Marvel collection, plus also the Jax figures, the 18-inch figures there. A little BB-8 light, which I got for Christmas. plus a Stormtrooper one as well, which I also got for Christmas from someone else. The old Avatar bits in the background there. These little mugs, these little cups, come from View Cinema Chain, so whenever a film comes out, they do a selection of about four or five different ones. Yes, home cinema of the year. Some more Jack specific figures there. Hopefully I want to get a few more of them when they come out. Plus the Enterprise from the new Star Trek series. This is the other canvas I was telling you about, which I got. I just saw it and I just fell in love with it. And this was in one of the B&Q stores. So this is, you know, this is Force Awakens. And this is the some of the collection of the Eagle Moss Marvel movie collection figures. So that's starting to really build up there. Another load. So I'm going to have to get another plinth soon, so I can put some more figures on. Vampire Diaries, this is actually signed by the cast. So Paul Wesley there, Ian Somerhalder, and Nina Dobrev. Couple of figures. Yes, got DTS HD, Dolby True HD. I need to get another one there to show that it's got Dolby Atmos. This is a lenticular poster, so this has got some depth, but you can't really see it from the video. 3D projector there, full 3D. And this is the Eagle Moss Star Trek collection, which I got up to about 110 or 120, and then I just stopped collecting because they were bringing out some of the really rare, obscure ships. So I got all the ones that I wanted. Got a whole Klingon section there and that. I tried to keep like Federation all together. And these are the larger ones. So they're about twice or three times the size. Yeah, so I've got my Skybox there, the amplifier, Blu-ray player, which is multi-region, and PlayStation 4. Big old screen there with the curtains.
Yeah, one other thing that I'll point out, when you had a look around the room, you probably saw a couple of plinths with some little figures on. They are actually Eagle Moss figures, and they are the Marvel movie edition. So they're releasing characters of every single, basically, models of every character from the Marvel movies. So I think that's going to go on and on and on. And also, like the Star Trek ships behind me, they went on for quite a while. So yeah, well, I hope you enjoyed this little video. It's not a big update this week. But yeah, head over to cudzndrips.com. Keep an eye on my group buys, my Steelbook group buys. I've got the Accountant running, which is an HMV one. I've also got a couple of others, Jack Reacher 2. So go off, head off, put your name down. I'll pick you up a couple, a copy or two. We've got a Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them Steelbook coming up from HMV in a couple of weeks, so that should be good. And what with all the big summer films that are coming up, that should be quite exciting, so I'll highlight some of those. So don't forget to give me the thumbs up if you like the video, and also any comments or criticisms you want to put down, just jot it down below in the comments below. And yeah, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.